Unit 1. I'm going to explain the vocab now. Okay. Number 1. Moan. Number 1. Moan. What is the meaning of moan? Complain. What is the meaning of moan? Complain. Let's have an example. She keeps moaning that she has no time. She keeps complaining that she has no time to do anything. She keeps moaning. She keeps complaining that she has no time. That's why she's crying here. She's moaning. So the example here, let's look at number one. Moan. She keeps moaning that she has no time. Moan means complain. Okay, let's go to number two. The word number two, ban. Ban. What is the meaning of ban? Not allow. What is the meaning of ban? Not allow. For example, the city has banned smoking in all public buildings. The city has banned smoking in all public buildings. This means that smoking is not allowed here. Smoking is not allowed in this public buildings. So let's have an example here. The city has banned smoking in all public buildings. Number two. So ban means not allow. Another example. So this means that mobiles are not allowed here. Mobiles are not allowed here. Okay. Mobiles are banned here. Okay. So let's go to complicated. Complicated. What is the meaning of complicated? Word number three, complicated. Complicated means difficult. What is the meaning of complicated? Difficult. So, let's have an example. Look here, the girl. This girl said, this sum is complicated. So, this sum is difficult. This sum is complicated. This sum is difficult. But this boy said, this sum is easy. This sum is easy. So complicated means difficult. Okay, so let's see an example now. That's a complicated question. That's a difficult question. That's a difficult sum. So complicated means difficult. Okay, let's go to number four. Give me a buzz or contact. Give me a buzz or contact means communicate with me or call me or chat with me. So give me a buzz means communicate with me or to call me. For example, when the kids come back, just give me a buzz and they will come. Just call me, just communicate with me and I will come. So when the kids come back, so please give me a buzz. So please communicate with me. Please call me and I will come. So give me a buzz means communicate with. Number five, invaluable. 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 What is the meaning of invaluable? Extremely useful. Extremely useful. For example, without her invaluable photographs, my presentation would have been boring. Without her invaluable, without her useful photographs, my presentation would have been boring, would have been very boring. So without the photographs, without the amazing and useful photographs, my presentation is going to be very boring, would have been very boring. So, for example, the books are invaluable. The books are invaluable, are extremely useful. The books are invaluable. The books are extremely useful for the children or for the kids, for anyone. So, let's go to number six, risk. Risk. So, he's thinking now, I think it's a risk. I think there is something dangerous. I think it's a risk. I think there is something dangerous. Okay? So risks here means dangers. Risks here means dangers. So let's see an example. You are taking a big risk driving so fast. So if you are driving so fast, so it's a big danger. It's a big danger. So risks means dangers. Risks means dangers. So here it's a risk. To walk on a rope, it's a risk. So it's something dangerous. It's something dangerous. Okay, so we finished. Risk means dangers. Let's go to number 7. Trends. Trends. So what the meaning of trends? It's written up here. Fashion. What the meaning of trends? Fashion. Okay. Let's go. Did you see the fashion? Did you see what are they wearing here? So this is fashion. These are trends. These are trends. So let's have an example. There is a new trend towards mini skirts this year. There is a new trend towards mini skirts this year. So trends means fashion. So there is a new trend about mini skirts, short skirts this year. So it's a fashion. It's a fashion. Let's go to number 8. Gets on my nerves means annoys me, makes me angry. Did you see this man? Did you see this creature? So gets on my nerves. What the meaning of gets on my nerves? They are getting on my nerves means they annoy me. They annoy me. They make me angry. Okay. So let's have an example. The noise of those children. The noise those children make gets on my nerves. The noise that the children make annoys me. The noise that the children make annoys me, makes me angry. So gets on my nerves means annoy me. So here they are getting on my nerves. For example, the noise of those children the noise those children make gets on my nerves. So gets on my nerves means annoy me. Annoy me, okay? Annoys me or makes me angry. Gets on my nerves. Did you see? So here she's saying, the noise those children make gets on my nerves. The noise those children make gets on my nerves. Gets on my nerves. Annoys me. Makes me angry. Let's see number 9. Gadgets. Gadgets. What are the meaning of gadgets? Useful devices. Useful devices. Machines. Useful machines. Useful equipments. Useful tools. Okay. Useful devices. So, for example, did you see? It's like, for example, mixer. It's like laptop, printer, router, mouse, microphone. All of this are gadgets. So let's see an example here. It's a clever little gadget which you can use to cut vegetables into attractive shapes. So it's an amazing device which can cut the vegetables into an amazing shapes. Amazing shapes. So gadget means useful devices. Okay, let's go to the last word, which is save up. Our last word is save up. Okay, save up to 20% or 50% or whatever. So what the meaning of save up? Collect money. What the meaning of save up? Collect money. So here he's saving up. Okay, he's saving up his money. Means he is collecting his money in order to buy something. So let's have an example. It took me ages to save up enough money to go traveling. So it took me ages to save up enough money to go traveling. It took me ages to save up. To save up, to collect money. To go traveling. To go traveling. So this is save up. So now we finished the vocab. These are the reading. You can read the reading from your book, Code Unit 1, Person to Person. These are the new vocabs. Okay. And I'm going to answer with you, which is more important, is the exercise of vocab, page 7. Exercise. Which is here, find words in the text that mean complain. We said what is the meaning of complain? Moan. Not allow means ban. Difficult means complicated. Communicate with means give her a buzz or contact. Extremely useful, we said invaluable. Dangers, risks. Fashions, trends. Annoys me, gets on my nerves. Useful devices, gadgets. Collecting money means saving up. So these are the vocabs. Study them well by heart and you can read the passage. And I'm going to send you a sheet, PDF, to do it by yourselves about the vocab. Thank you.